Hi Founder fans, Jason here. Today's founder is Joseph Hawley, and though he has no known image, he was one of the most important and underappreciated early rebels leading up to the Revolutionary War in colonial Boston. Joseph Hawley, he actually studied theology and became a school teacher for a while, but this didn't suit him, and he ends up changing his profession and becomes a lawyer. And he's in this position throughout the 1760s, while the mother country's issuing all these new taxes, and Joseph Hawley doesn't like them. And he speaks up very loudly. In fact, we know the name Sam Adams, and many of us know the name James Otis, but Joseph Hawley was right up with them, and if not even louder, screamer about these new tax policies. Now, Hawley, during this time, takes on another young lawyer who he mentors by the name of John Adams, and John Adams is essentially Hawley's protege. It's during this time that John Adams is also radicalized, and eventually the call goes out for the first Continental Congress to meet. Hawley is at the secret meeting where they choose delegates to go to Massachusetts, and he's actually nominated as one of the people to go, but it's decided not to send him because he never had, nor was he inoculated against, smallpox. And Philadelphia was known to be a bit of a hotbed for smallpox. Adams and the other people had either received it or, like John Adams, been inoculated beforehand earlier in their life. Hawley stays home, but he writes a letter called the Broken Hints Letter to John Adams, which, among many things, outlines what should happen. He actually thinks the main goal of the First Continental Congress should be to organize an army, even though it's about 9 months before the Battle of Lexington and Concord when he's writing this letter. He predicts violence will erupt, and he thinks the main thing should be to enforce this. Additionally, he understands, and most people expected, a boycott to be a result of the First Continental Congress, and he thought a united army would be important for enforcing said boycott. Additionally, he talks about the needs of union. Again, this is about 13 years before the United States Constitution is written, and Alexander Hamilton, for example, is about 17 years old when Hawley's writing this letter, and he says how important the Union is. In fact, I have a quote here from him. It's, quote, "Every grievance of any one colony must be held and considered by the whole as a grievance to the whole, and must operate on the whole as a grievance to the whole. This would be a difficult matter to effect, but it must be done." I know he uses the word whole a lot there, but what he's saying is, if one colony is upset, then all the colonies should be upset. We should be united together. It will be a difficult matter to effect, but it must be done. He's essentially predicting the United States Constitution. Unfortunately, after 1776, Hawley kind of disappears from the show, which seems to be an occurrence with many of the early revolutionaries in Boston. So when he was a teenager, Hawley's father had committed suicide, and the famous preacher, Jonathan Edwards, the Great Awakening preacher, actually gave a sermon saying how the reason he had these mental health issues and decided to kill himself, Hawley's father was sinful. And it was the sin that drove him to kill himself. Hawley didn't care for this at all. Many people, by this point, Jonathan Edwards was wearing on a lot of people's, wearing under their skin, as they say. And Hawley was the leader, this Joseph Hawley was the leader in pushing Jonathan Edwards out of his church that he was in at the time. Now, these psychological problems seem to have been inherited because just after the First Continental Congress, Hawley has a mental breakdown. And they said the word that they use is dimmed. His awareness seems to have been dimmed after this. So not only could he not really practice law, but he couldn't really contribute to the revolution at all, which is a shame because he was a major leader before the revolution. And as someone calling for union well before anyone else I've ever seen call for a union of the colonies, he most assuredly would have been some kind of leader at the federal level. So that is the sad ending to the story of Joseph Hawley. I hope you learned a little something today. If you did, do me a favor and hit like. If you're new here, subscribe. I put out videos about the American Revolution all week long, and I'll be back with another founder for you tomorrow.